a religion. I'm not gonna join the Baptist church. That's right. Gonna be a Baptist preacher so that I won't have to work. Well, I'm in the pulpit, jumping up and down, 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 down. Yeah, I'm in the pulpit, jumping up and down. Okay. Well, I'm hollering good news all miles around. Sister jumped up now, ooh, and she began to grin. Yes, she did. Well, my sister jumped up, ooh, she began to grin. She said, good Lord have mercy, please forgive me for my sins.
We just thought we'd like to tell you how you can help support this podcast. If you like what we're doing, we've come up with a way to help us support it because there are certain costs involved and, you know, we can't keep using Joyce's credit card.
She's fuming.
Gone off on one. And so we've joined buymeacoffee.com/Finnegan's.
So if you want to support the pod, all you need to do is go to that website and there you can buy us a pint.
It's a costly pint, Tom.
It's a fiver for a pint. It's Southern prices. Blame the Tories. That's what I say. Yeah. Or secondly, you can become a member at Finnegan's. And so you give so much a month. And there's three different tiers for that. The first tier gets your name in the credits at the end of the podcast. The second tier gets you a shout out during the pod. And finally, the third tier gets you on the wall.
Put them on the wall, lad.
So we've got loads of ideas with the pod, how we want to develop it and see it grow. But if you would like to support us, it's always going to be free, the podcast. But if you'd like to support us, then you can do that by visiting buymeacoffee.com/Finnegan's.
Thank you.
Good evening.
Evening.
We're in.
How are you doing?
Doing good, mate. Cheers. Yeah. Fantastic. Yeah.
What are we drinking, Sam?
Birra Moretti.
We are.
Fancy.
We are. Off the pump.
Let us know what you're drinking at home tonight. Welcome to Wednesday night at Finnegan's. It's great to be in for another session at the bar.
It is. We've got Jack in, haven't we?
We've
gone all big time. Billy Big Time. We've got our own producer.
Our own producer.
What's going on?
I don't quite know how we managed to do that, but it's happened.
I know. I can't. And so he's here.
You can't see him because we don't trust him with a camera or a microphone on him.
Not yet.
We're going to ease him in.
Yeah.
And
we haven't got another camera.
So Jack will basically kind of hover in the background and do things
that you normally have to
do.
Which is why, you know, when he's pulling funny faces sometimes, he's going, it's because he's trying to do four things at once.
So if I'm pulling a funny face this week, then it's just my face.
It's your funny
face,
yeah.
There's no excuses. Yeah. So fantastic. Welcome Jack in the chat for us. But sadly, already I think he's broken the chat instantly. So I'm going to keep an eye. I'll be pulling funny faces looking at my phone. But good evening. Thank you for joining us all.
Who's in?
Ray's in. Dan's in. Nice to see you. Fantastic. What's everyone drinking? Let us know what you're having. My dad's in. I always like when dad's watching. That's good. My Emma, she's in. Jackie's in. Marg's is in. Fantastic. Ray's. Yeah, Ray's.
Ray's in. You've already said that.
Oh, yeah. Jack's plucked from the back of the church at last. Yeah. So we've stolen Jack. Yeah. So Jack kind of, he's done the tech at church, hasn't he, for a while.
Jack now lives in the in Finnegan's, doesn't he?
He does.
Lives
well, here. He turned 18 the other day, he's allowed
that's
in.
Why he can come. Yeah.
And we've put him on a zero.
He isn't on the wall, though.
He's not on the wall.
No.
We'll see.
Is he still on trial?
He's on trial.
Okay.
This is a probation period, and if it goes wrong...
He's bad, lad.
He's bad, lad. Yeah. We'll see what happens.
See what happens with Jack.
We've got a top night. Sorry, I don't know why I did that. It's the hands. Now I've not got have to do things here. The hands feel like, what are they going to do?
Jazz hands.
We've got a top night for you tonight.
We have.
We've got Helen Jones and Paul Beesley, and they brought us gifts. Look at that.
This aprons. Is a bag. It's not an apron. That's bag for life.
Bag, tote bag. All the kids are wearing them. Alan's wearing it over his head.
Easier to carry, isn't it?
So I tell you what.
Always shopping in there. Laughing at
each. You are
old. Yeah, that's what you're looking for. So old.
So your glasses. So basically
£2 them old
stop talking each you week we have nugget of the week, and basically nugget of the week is someone who comes up with a great comment, a funny comment during the course of the conversation, maybe a funny question, or they've got something for our guests. I'm going to keep an eye, don't worry, and if you win, then I'll send you one of these BBC Radio Merseyside bags with one of these in it. Should we do the test?
We need to test, don't we?
So Helen and Paul, this is your first test. Let's welcome them to start. Yeah, let's say hello to Helen and Paul. Nice to have you in.
A bit of applause.
Give them a round of applause. Nice to see you. So Helen and Paul, this could set the tone for the evening, but I need to ask you, what do you call one of these? A nugget bar. Let me get your mics on. Say that again for me.
Nugget.
What
nugget
would you have called
I'd say
that, Helen?
Nugget as well.
You would say nugget. Yeah. All right.
See,
that's fine.
It's just you Tory, Tom.
I would say nougat.
He says nougat.
Is that not you? You definitely wouldn't say nougat.
I've never even heard of it.
Yeah. No.
I've never heard of nougat.
Well, all right.
Until you come up here and start saying your Tory stuff.
That is a thing.
It's not a thing.
No.
Never heard that. Not up
here. Not at all. Okay. See,
Jack's fallen asleep already. What are you doing?
Jack
he's picking his nails. Teenagers today. I don't even know what he's doing.
What's he doing? What are you up to?
So, just for you guys, to let you know what you're in for tonight. Basically, every Wednesday, me and Alan, we hang out at Finnegan's Bar for the evening. Yeah. We welcome a whole load of people who come and join us to watch for the night.
Yeah.
We have a chat. What do we chat about, Al?
Nothing.
Nothing and everything.
We just chat nonsense, don't we, most of the time.
Have you ever been to the pub with your mates and you just feel like you solve all the problems of the world and by the end of the night you think, what, that was just a fantastic evening. And so that's what this is tonight. So we're going to ask you guys a little bit about radio, a little bit about your life, faith. We've got a funny story and we've got wonky donkey to come up. So if you've got any questions for Paul or for Helen, then chuck them in the chat and we'll ask them for them in a little bit when we get to that part.
They've brought their banner in, their Radio Merseyside banner.
Look. We come all set with our own stage set.
What a wonky donkey, a wonky banner.
Wonky banner,
Feel that. Fantastic. And we've got, we had some good news this week, didn't we, Al?
We had some boss news, We've been trying to get some money because the interest just keeps going on this credit card, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And it's killing us, 29.9% APR or something like that.
On Joyce's credit card, which paid for this wonderful piece of equipment, getting more expensive all the time.
We started a Buy Me a Coffee page, didn't we?
We did.
Which is a way of supporting us if you want to. It's always, this will always be free everyone. But we've got a thing, buymeacoffee.com/Finnegan's.
We have.
See the way I remembered that?
Very good.
Yeah. Which you can help support us if you want. So there's different ways you can do that. You can buy us a pint.
There was an advert at the beginning that explained it.
Well, what did you ask me for then?
Basically, three people supported us this week and they supported us as VIP nuggets. So that means they've given a tenner a month make this happen. And so as part of that, what happens?
Get them on the wall,
They go on the wall. Yeah. And so, fantastic. We're going to put Margs up.
Yeah.
Margs, congratulations. That's the best £10 a month you've ever spent. There goes Margs. Who else was it? Josh.
Can't you remember?
I can. I'm just testing.
Oh, you're testing me.
Yeah.
I think you're testing yourself. Yeah, go on.
Who's the last one? Kathleen. Very good.
I can't spell Kathleen.
Kathleen. So yeah. Fantastic. Thank you so much for your support. If you want to support us, you can go to buymeacoffee.com/Finnegans. And if you did it during
that at the beginning,
if you do it during the episode, it will come up
it
on
will.
The screen.
It will.
Do you know
it
what?
Surprise
that's,
us.
That would be quite exciting because that's never happened before. So if you want to surprise us with that, we would love that. But that's how you do it. Anyway, fantastic. So good. Yeah. So
absolutely, boss. So thanks, everybody.
Thank you for your support. Yeah. Much appreciated.
Keeps it going, doesn't it? Because there is costs.
Yeah.
Which we're finding more and more with streaming licenses things that you'd have to just have legally. So
we do.
Yeah, never mind.
Christine's in. Mike's in. Pete's in. Nice to see you, mate. Let's see what questions we've got. Ah, Jackie said, hi, Paul and Helen. I was listening to Helen's show on Merseyside earlier today.
Excellent. Good choice.
Helen, what show do you do? Which show are you on?
So I present the afternoon show Monday to Wednesday, and it's on 2 till 6. And it's great to know that someone's
watching.
Yeah. And linked to the bar as well, listening. Which is cool.
Listening.
Sorry, it's radio, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. Helen, you've got straight away, but you've got a fantastic voice, haven't you?
Thank you.
That's good. That is amazing.
It's a proper
Paul,
radio
let's
voice.
Check your...
My voice.
Your voice. Yeah, go on. Yeah. Oh,
well, my
nice
voice
well.
Is different to Helen's voice. But,
it is.
You know,
it's different.
It's still a voice. Yeah,
but it's great.
Yeah.
I think we need to get you guys to do some sort of promo.
Training for you.
Yeah. Well, yeah, well, train.
We should try it, shouldn't we? We should. Should have radio voices. Me and you. Go on, give us your best radio.
Well,
voice.
No, I don't know what I say. What do I say? What would you say? Welcome to.
Well, welcome us here as disc jockeys. Then welcome to the bar.
Are you putting on a voice, or is that just your voice when you're doing?
Dare you. My voice.
You're a southerner. When you were on it before.
Oh no, I'm from the Wirral.
Are you? Okay,
yes.
A wool. Local. Is that what they say? A
yes.
Wool.
I beg your pardon.
You're not from calling you a wolf.
Mr. Nougar.
Sorry.
Mr. Nougar calling it a wolf.
But what would you say on drive time when you come back? Would you say something
I
that
would
we could
say? So
practice.
If you guys were rocking up on my show, let's say we're on rehearsal, I would say, welcome on in. Thanks for joining me today on BBC Radio Merseyside. In with me this afternoon, I've got the lovely Alan and Tom. And we're going to be talking about sweets. Is it nugget or nougat?
Wow.
See?
That's
how you do
that.
It, Tom.
That is very good.
Yeah.
And so, you've had Alan on before the show, haven't you?
Alan and I, yes, in a previous life when I used to cover quite a lot the Late Show. There was a series of panellists that would come in, and it was a set. That was it Wednesday nights, Al?
Wednesday nights,
Oh, he's replaced it with this.
Yeah. Indeed, yes. So, I never like thought it more of here, that. Because there's alcohol. And there was Alan.
The first one I ever did was wine tasting.
Oh, right.
Wow.
With Whiny John.
There's a theme
Whiny
here.
John.
Whiny John we had on. I don't know his name.
Did it get worse?
Whiny
like
John.
No. Yeah. And it was a setup a bit like this, and we kind of talk about different things. And there was Gary from St. Helens behind the dream, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Was it Safina?
That's
was
the
you
big
guys?
Ed on the M52.
Yes.
M62.
And the statue.
Big Ed on the M62.
Nice.
My mate, Joe Ward, it is.
That's it.
I used to work with a fella called Joe Ward, and he had the biggest head you've ever seen. Like every time I drive past that, still do it to today. I ring him up and I go, Joe, you're rubbish at hide and seek. I can see you. You're in the woods.
So did Alan ever say anything inappropriate or get you into trouble? Did you ever get complaints?
We had some scary moments.
Okay.
If people were texting in, I would always say, don't just read out first of all what you see, just in case there's a naughty word in there.
Say what you see. Yeah.
But Al was quite racy, weren't you, Alan?
I don't know.
Yes, you were. And you'd always talk. I mean, tonight I've met the lovely Diane. Hadn't met her at all.
No, that's not mine.
You've blown him up there. His wife's not called Diane.
That's Gary's wife, Diane.
Oh, Diane.
Joyce,
I'm so sorry.
She'll be watching. She'll be fuming now.
But you
who's
always
Diane?
Used to...
Exactly, yeah.
Diane was the apartment. But I always used to worry and feel sorry.
You wake up
for
with determination
wife,
and you go to bed with satisfaction.
Joyce's bought you two beers. She's one for you, one for Diane.
Nice one, Joyce.
Thanks, Joyce. Cheers. Thank you, Joyce.
Calm down, Joyce. That's a Joyce bank account. That guy.
The idea is we're raising funds to pay you back, Joyce, not that you end up in more debt.
Just paying your all.
Anyway. Yeah.
Dear me.
That was our mate from Australia. We had a fella all the way from Australia come and join us in Finnegan's, and this was his catchphrase.
You wake up with determination and you go to bed with satisfaction.
You wake up with satisfaction. You wake up,
You
wake up with determination, you go to bed with satisfaction. That would be what he'd say. There you go, Helen.
You wake up with determination and you go to bed with satisfaction.
Oh, how Australian is that voice? And, well, oh, straight.
Yeah.
You should have seen his band. Oh,
he had a mullet.
He had a proper mullet.
I don't know if he's in tonight. No, he normally watches first thing in the morning, and but he's a very good guy. He What's been happening this week, Alan?
What's it? Well, you've done your roof, I think.
Nice.
Got you.
Did you have notes of that? How did you tame him, Helen? Paul, did you ever... did Helen tell you not to have Paul, not to have Alan on your show?
Well, you know, we'd have Alan on any time. In fact, we're talking about bringing him on pretty soon.
Really?
So, and you?
Yeah. We'll wait and see how this goes, Paul. That's what I'm saying, because he's... how did you handle him? How did you keep him? Because I struggle to keep him in check sometimes, Helen.
Because it's radio, a lot of gestures.
That
no one can see.
That's good. Like, correct, this one.
Yes. And worse, but I can't repeat them. But I think as well, with Alan's role as a Baptist minister, you've been on other programs as well. And I know that Paul was going to sign the deal to negotiate getting you on quite quickly to be BBC Radio Merseyside.
And you.
I'll be there with bells on.
You're driving.
The news guy.
That's how Alan normally gets gigs. He ends up driving the comedian around and they give him 5 minutes as part of the deal.
Yeah, you see 5 minutes, lad. You can say some new stuff if you want.
Because our news is Paul has just taken over a really fantastic slot on BBC Radio Merseyside.
Congratulations, Paul.
Well, Helen was doing the Sunday show for 10 years, weren't you?
Wow.
Daybreak Sunday breakfast show for 10 years.
You were involved in that though as well, weren't you?
Yeah, I was involved with it. Yeah, that's right. Which is probably where I met you.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. Were you a producer at her first or something like that?
That's right. Yeah.
Because I remember talking to you on the phone and all that before.
Well, we've worked together for over 10 years now, haven't we? Over 10 years. So, and now, I'm presenting it on the Sunday morning. We're going to get you guys on in a couple of weeks' time.
Yeah.
So people will be able to listen to that. We'll have a bit of fun.
It'll be ace.
Yeah.
Just looking at the comments, someone says, hi, Helen and Paul. Mike says, hi, Helen and Paul. Paul has made himself a millionaire working on BBC Radio Merseyside.
Made himself a millionaire?
He works on three different shows a day.
What a guy.
I wish.
Yeah.
What a guy. I've not
seen the Wonga.
I've not seen the Wonga either.
The men do get paid more than the women on the BBC, Helen. I don't know if you've clocked that.
Do they?
Fantastic. She's good, that, Helen. Just swerve that one right off. We had Peter Dowd on last week. He was slippery as well.
He was great, we had Peter on. He was
very
great.
Good.
Yeah. So, no, it was my birthday this week.
It was Alan's birthday.
You're going for, isn't it?
So, wait.
Yesterday.
I want you to guess. Just look into this face and tell me how old you think he is. And don't hold back.
Okay.
Just be honest. How old do you think Alan is?
I'm going to say
54.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm going to say 56.
Higher or lower?
Have a little guess at home now. If you how old do you think Alan is? I'll have a little look in the comments. Jack, what would you say about this fella here? Look in his face. You can see the pain in the eyes.
That's just it. It's just the arthritis kicking in. It's me hips sitting on this stool.
How old did you say he is? Oh, 55.
We've gone 54, 55, 56. Yeah. Any higher than a six?
Go on, let people know.
How old am I? How old do you know?
Yeah.
Go on,
56.
Then. I'm 56,
Well done.
Oh, there we go.
What, did you say 56?
Yeah, so 56.
You get an extra sweet for that.
You do.
You get an extra triangle off the toll,
oh,
whatever it is.
53, 56. People are saying 60. It's going up. It's going up. No. Tal's just said old enough for a bus pass.
Nearly,
56.
But
56. Tell you what, a lot of people are saying 56, but I think that's probably after you said you were 56.
That might be a bit of a clue,
that was the hint.
What do you think?
What did you get for your birthday?
I got some of these sweets. Look, these are nice. These can't eat them while you're talking. No, that's the thing.
These are
like little drops of heaven.
They are good, those.
You know, they're not as nice as the salted caramel ones. Just saying.
Yeah. Who got you those?
My daughter. So, massive fail, but never mind.
Disappointment.
Yeah. Got a pair of trainees.
See, Alan got a pair of trainees. So, his kids buy him the trainees. So, they're like, have you heard of? I don't want to patronize you.
No,
but have you heard of 110s?
110s, no.
No.
So 110s are like, they're Nike shoes that used to cost £110. And then that's why they're called 110s in Liverpool, because it's like a street.
It's the only
thing.
Place to call 110s.
They don't cost 110 anymore.
No,
they're probably more. Do you
the
think?
One, the 165.
But in 165, I don't know.
That's just
ring.
Roll off the tongue, doesn't it?
Has he got them on now?
No. So these are his birthday shoes.
No, these aren't.
Oh, sorry. Go on.
These aren't my birthdays.
They're the same
Christmas
make,
ones.
Though, are they?
Same make.
So are you 50p ones, Al?
These are home bargains. Home bargains best.
So these are the new ones. And what are they even called?
On cloud.
On cloud. So he's walking around on cloud.
On cloud nine. Because it was me birthday.
Essentially what you expect a drug dealer to be walking around in. And here comes this 65-year-old fella.
65. Oh, and I'm talking to him today. He says to me, what did you get for your birthday? So I'm talking and I said, oh, they got me a trip to the Emirates, to Old Trafford one, you know, for the cricket.
Yeah.
T20, yeah. England versus somebody, Australia, I think. And he's going, oh, when's that? And I'm like, it's in September sometime. Oh, yeah, that might be good, won't it? You're going.
I thought that was the surprise.
You're going.
When did you find that out? Before, did you know already when
Danny
we had the conversation?
Was here before and, no. Oh, and
he said, keep that a secret.
Tom's going. Because he said you're owing money still.
Yeah. No, I paid.
He said you've only paid for half your ticket, so you're not getting it.
You're
only coming for the first innings.
Oh, well, we'll see. I thought that was the treat. You got there, and then you see I'm there, and it's like, wow, what a birthday. Dreams do come true.
We're going in a party stand, apparently.
Are we?
Yeah, which is basically the big scaffold one.
Is it? That sounds like fun.
You ever been?
I've never been to the cricket, even though I'm a southerner. I've not done it.
No.
You're allowed to go.
To the cricket? Yeah. Is that a thing?
I've been to the test match.
Yeah.
The Ashes one.
This looks great.
England lost.
They make the snake out of all the beer, beers,
yeah,
don't they?
Yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
The
it's a good laugh.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Especially at 2020. I mean, what can go wrong in Manchester in September?
Yeah.
You know, cricket outdoors. Mm. Never rains in Manchester, does it?
No.
No, never. No.
What we've also started doing, Helen and Paul, just because our listeners quite like our take on the news and current affairs and events and stuff. So we had a little look at that. Do you see the story about the Chinese balloon?
Yeah.
Thing yes. that yeah. got
Helen's normally all over this type of stuff.
Do
this
you?
Is what
not
you used
tonight,
to do,
Helen.
Didn't you?
No, yeah.
what she used to do on the late show.
What, like talk about this kind of thing?
Seeing things on the news that happened. Aren't as massive
yeah.
news stories.
Night, Alan, was it your night when Nelson Mandela passed away? Nelson Mandela?
No, I wasn't. Yeah. I wasn't on that night. You were on, weren't you?
I think he passed away. It was announced at 10 to 10, and we were going live at 10. And it was kind of like, oh, okay. And Safina, who's part of the arts world of Liverpool, she's a great talker. Safina Aziz, her name is, and she was so fantastic. Just talked about him as a, you know, what he meant to her, and
wow,
as an ambassador, and you know, everything that, you know, he had done in his life. And then we took calls and had people.
Because that would have changed the whole show. Just
yeah,
that
because we couldn't be all yeah. jolly no, and yeah. stuff. We had to gauge it for a
That's
first.
Why I wasn't on. I think I got bumped.
Wise move.
Can you imagine?
Said, don't let him in.
That's probably right. Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's radio. You have to go with what happens, and you have to watch the songs that you play, and you have to be really sensitive. If it's like a murder case that we're following, or if it's something that you're not going to play all jolly music afterwards, because you have to... just really, you know, take the tone, don't you, Paul?
Yeah, you do. I mean, and that can happen anytime. You were on the Saturday Breakfast Show, weren't you? The morning after the... Do you remember the incident down at the Pierhead when Liverpool won the Premiership?
And, and all the fans gathered.
And yes, there was
Pier at the Live Building.
That's right. Yeah. And we come in to do a jolly Saturday morning breakfast show, and all of a sudden, everything was changed. We had the mayor on and what have you, didn't we?
So, and taking calls as well, because it was a big deal.
Yeah.
A
wow.
deal.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think we couldn't be trusted with that level of sophistication.
We definitely couldn't.
We've
just got to roll with what we've already done. No, I don't care what happens tonight. We're going to talk about this blue.
They've shot it down, haven't they?
It was an interesting story, that was.
Did you think it was a... Because the Chinese people just said it was a...
Weather balloon. A weather balloon,
Or was it a sneaky spot?
It was 200 foot. Big.
The size of this thing. So it was, what, 20 stories high, they said?
20 stories high.
20 story high.
That's a big balloon.
Yeah, it wasn't the type of balloon you buy in the Liverpool show and set it off with a label on and see where it lands up.
Yeah, Chinese lanterns, them ones that you light.
Yeah. Yes, you're not supposed to light them, are you now?
And I think they've banned them after,
they banned them,
I think.
Yeah.
And so I saw the video of them shooting it down.
Yeah.
And there was just it was just one missile.
He's just on a sidewinder at it. Yeah. I mean, who shoots a missile at a blue? The Americans are mad.
But I did read that there'd been one and probably... What was it, around 98? And it was over Canada, and they tried to shoot it down, and they couldn't get it down.
They shot a thousand bullets
at it, and they couldn't get it down.
I mean, there's been a few of them around. I mean, that one's just been brought in the news, hasn't it? But
yeah,
I think they've seen one in South America as well. Yeah, there's been a few of them around, you know.
It's
wow,
just, it's just madness though, shooting at that. I mean, how much was the rocket that they shot at this blue?
I think a missile's got to be.
It's a few bob, like
you can't get them cheap, can you? I mean, I don't speak constant facts, but I think that's probably got to be a few grand, isn't it?
It's got to be a couple of bob, more than a tenner, aren't they?
Like, anyway,
so the bloom up in smoke.
Helen and Paul, can you tell us a little bit about how you got into radio? I'd love to hear a little
you
bit.
You go first, Paul.
I've always loved radio. I've always loved listening to radio. Even when I was as little, I used to go to bed listening to the radio. I love shortwave radio. You know, just going through a radio and finding what you came across. And you didn't know where they were. And it might be some really exotic country. You know, this is the days before the internet and everything else. So I've always loved radio. And I also work as a tour guide in the city. And I've worked a lot with the media, sort of travel programs that have come in, you know, so the Judith Chalmers of Germany and things like that. so I've always enjoyed that sort of stuff. And then around about 2009, I through a friend, got involved with Radio Merseyside, actually on the Sunday morning breakfast show.
Okay.
When Helen was, you were sort of doing cover, weren't you, on the show at the time?
There's a guy called Wayne Clark.
Yeah, Wayne Clark.
Also a Baptist.
He's a Baptist. He was in Liverpool.
Yeah.
So I just got involved volunteering, doing little bits and pieces here and there, making the tea, anything like that. And it just went from there, really. And then in 2012, became much more involved with the Sunday show and with other shows as well. And it just went from there, you know. So it was out of a genuine interest in radio that I, you know, got involved, really.
Yeah.
But do you have to have the voice for the get-go? Does the voice come after a while, or because
I mean, this is my voice. So you know, I don't speak any differently when I'm doing anything else. Really,
you've been blessed with it, there, haven't you? You've got it.
I don't think you need a radio voice. You know, it's all. I'm not sure I've got a radio voice, but you know, there's plenty of people.
You've got a radio voice.
Different voices.
Yeah.
Who are good on radio. It's all about, I mean, what they say on radio is it's all about talking to that one person.
Okay.
It might be in the car, in their living room, painting the shed. You're talking to that one. No matter how many people are listening, it's you're talking to one person.
We often are only talking to one person, aren't we? That's the part of the problem.
No one's talking to us today with the feed.
We are.
No one's talking to us, yeah.
But it's the soothing voice that you've got.
Helen used to say to us, smile when you talk.
Yeah.
That was a tip. So you'd be brilliant, wouldn't you? Look at you, Cheshire cat. Yeah.
I just think, so for me, my story was, I'm the only girl and I'm the youngest and I had older brothers and they wouldn't let me go fishing or play cricket or whatever. So my friend was the wireless. So I would listen to Radio Luxembourg. I'd take the charts and I'd, you know, write to disc jockeys and say, can you send me a picture? And there was a particular broadcaster called Ray Moore Scouser. He used to do the voice commentary for the Miss World competitions and he was on Radio 2 and I was only young and I just thought, wow, he's a bit like what you're saying about us. He just had this really gentle and great voice. I just thought he was in the room with me, older than, you know, that I was a kid at school. And I thought, do you know what? One day I want to be like Ray and I want to be the voice for other people that are on their own or their brothers won't let them play with them and stuff. So at the grand age of 15, shall I rephrase that? Sorry. At the grand age of 15, I entered a DJ competition.
Wow.
I think it's Heart now, maybe, in Wrexham, but it was MFM and Marcher Sound. And there were 7 lads and 3 girls. My mum was very strict Irish Catholic. Yeah. And at the time, I think Elton John was in the press for doing drugs and it was all a bit, you know, sex, drugs, rock and roll. So my mum was very, you'll be a teacher. You're not doing that. So I proved to my mum that I really wanted to do it. And I think I was 13 and then 15. The competition happened and my mum was very, and so I got the train by myself, played 2 records, Aha and a Madonna song. And all I did, lads, was just reel off a big long list of schoolmates, Helen, Lorraine, Joanna.
I'm just saying hello to my mates
over the intro of the Aha song. Yeah. Anyway, weeks went by and they said, whoever played this song has won the competition and the prize was a half-hour slot introducing the Lost Pets. I'd made it.
Wait a second. The Lost Pets?
Yeah, so
what's that?
My dog's gone missing.
Oh, so if people... they put that on radio.
That was back then. So they don't do like, it now.
Oh, wow.
It's on Facebook now instead. Exactly. Anyone seen me, cat? Yeah, it's lying in their old song. So
weeks went by, and my mum was hanging the washing out, and I bought the little transistor radio, and then the opening bars of the Aha song came on, and I went, Mum, it's me. Well, she changed then. Local press came round.
Oh, she loved that. My daughter, absolutely loved it.
That. So, yeah. And that was the very beginning that I got the taste for it. But I think I was early teens. And what I love is I went then back to my old school, who were a bit, Al, you would appreciate this as well, because I know you can't stop talking, is the amount of detentions I got for talking. So I went back to say, yeah. I'm now doing radio. So thank you.
It was worth it.
Yeah, it was worth it.
All them half hours were worth it.
It was.
Dinner time detentions, yeah.
So I am blessed. I'm extremely lucky to have been in a position where I always feel your life's in chapters and you can meet people that encourage you or inspire you. And Ray Moore, for me, if you don't know who he is, check him out on Wikipedia or whatever. But a great guy. And the sadness about Ray Moore, the one thing he loved doing was broadcasting, and in the end, he got throat cancer.
Oh.
So his book that is still available was called Tomorrow Is Too Late. So I read that, and I thought, you know what? So a bit of the whole doing radio for me,
wow,
it was this Scouser guy who would never know me from Adam, but yeah, he will know.
Well, he might be watching.
Yeah.
You never know.
But
shout out to Ray. Come on.
Amazing.
Can't see any of your chat because it's not on here.
This chat's broken today. I don't know. Jack had one job today. And it broke instantly. It's not Jack's fault. He didn't do it.
Is it your fault then?
Because
everyone knows I can't do tech, so it's not my fault, is it?
Right. Oh, I'm keeping an eye on the chat, so let us know. Pete's saying, yes, positive energy and a cheeky smile. That's what he put
was
down.
Paul? It's the alcohol.
Yeah. And Mark says, yeah, when she worked on the phones, we were told to smile while you dial. You can hear a smile down the line, even though you can't see it.
There we go.
Helen,
there we go.
Exactly what you're saying.
There you go.
Not just for radio.
Yeah. Just in life in general.
Paul, tell us about Sunday morning show then.
Yeah, the Sunday morning show. It's the breakfast show. It's the faith show. So we look at loads of faith-related issues. We try to keep it light and shade. There's some weeks there's some very serious stuff on there. Other weeks it's a little bit lighter. So the first hour of the show, we'll play some faith-related best bits from the earlier parts of the week's output. We sort of go up a notch after 7 o'clock when we have some guests on.
When people wake up.
Wake up. Yeah. We just start listening. We talk to ourselves for the first hour. People start to wake up a little bit. We have guests. Well, sometimes they're national guests. Sometimes they're local guests. Could be looking at all sorts of stories.
Yeah.
It could be Christian, Jewish, Hindu, whatever, Muslim. It doesn't really matter. And then in the third hour of the show, we have a team of people who are, well, we refer to them as the Daybreak Regulars, and they come from different denominations. And they'll come in, they'll look at the papers, they'll have a bit of a paper review. We'll chat to them about a big story of the day. And then just before 9 o'clock, they have what we call a Sunday reflection, which is a bit of a sort of a message. Just hand the microphone over to them for 10 minutes to talk. And then the final hour, and this is where you guys may well step in. We have something called Sunday Essentials. And basically, it's a longer chat with people. We just sort of kick back a little bit. We ease off the gas and we just talk. We talk about whatever, you know, is their story.
Yeah.
And we just chat for as long as is needed to take you through. And we've had some great guests on that. We had the Reverend Henry Corbett, who worked at St. Peter's Church in Everton since 1975.
Yeah.
Not
wow.
from, a bit like you, Tom, not from Liverpool. Moved to Liverpool.
Whoa.
Worked in like a pillar of the community in Everton.
Yeah.
Everybody knows him and loves him, and he's about to retire. And then we had the chief executive of Nugent, the Catholic charity, on last week. A woman called Normandy. She's Canadian. Just about to resign, not resign, just about to retire and go back.
Sounds more pop.
Normandy, apologies for that. But she's going back to Canada. So,
okay. Yeah, all sorts of things like
that. It's been illegal here for years.
So it's just that, you know, it's a breakfast show through a sort of faith lens. And it's not, some weeks, you know, we have some heavy subjects on. We've been talking about the, you know, the Church of England and same-sex marriages and things like that. We've had people like Franklin Graham on in the past as well, when he came to Liverpool. We try not to shy away from the big issues, the controversial issues.
Great.
And listeners are not just faith-based listeners. Yeah, we get all sorts of listeners on. You know, we'll often get texts and things in completely disagreeing with what the guests are saying. Yeah. That's what it's all about.
I remember being in work one Sunday morning when I was building, right? And Phil Jump goes on occasionally. He does. He's our boss, Tom, in case you don't know who he is. And he was on the show, and I'm sitting there just before we go to it. It was about 7:30 in the morning or something like that. And he's on, and I said, he's my boss. And they went, is he? I went, yeah. Do you reckon he's left his phone on? So I got my phone and rang him, and he'd left it on. And he was he come off it. He come out of the studio, and he went, you did that on purpose, didn't you? And I went, yeah. And he went, why would you do that? And I went, because it's funny. Why would you leave your phone on? So, yeah, he's been on a few times, Phil.
He's one of our regulars, one of our Daybreak regulars. Yeah. And the great thing was, through the pandemic,
he's going to give us some money for this podcast.
Good for you. Nice one, Phil.
Well done, Phil.
Thanks, Phil.
Through the pandemic, they kept going. And what was the really nice thing, wasn't it? We got this comment on all of our shows.
That lifeline, wasn't it?
People just ringing in saying, do you know what? This has been a lifeline for me. And we still get this today, even without the pandemic. People who literally from day to day don't talk to anyone.
Yeah.
Wow. They don't see anyone. They don't talk to anyone. But they switch on the radio in the morning, and they switch it off when they go to bed at night, and they keep it on. It's like that friend in the room. And we get this comment, don't we, on all the shows?
And I think as well, Tom, on a Sunday, especially during COVID, many people, Alan was delighted that there was no one there, but they were at home, and their routines were changed. So we had to fill that little space out the smart speaker to say, what are they missing? How can we try and be that extra little bit of support on the Sunday? Because people weren't able to see anyone. People were poorly.
It
was brill for some, but I think for the majority of our listeners,
tough time.
And a changing time, because many people's routines, have they gone back, or have they decided that they want to do services online now?
I had to go back. I had to. They wouldn't let me stay in the house anymore.
Well, you did.
Front of a camera.
The whole online thing, though.
We did the online thing. Yeah, we changed our whole services, didn't we?
And would you get? I mean, that would be great, because you get overseas people, wouldn't you?
We had Southerners watching, didn't we?
Oh, okay. The walls.
The walls.
But I think a lot of churches said that, you know, we actually, in many respects, increased the people with whom we had contact, because there were people there who had never been to us. We didn't even know who they were, but every week they would tune in.
Yeah, we definitely had the same.
We had hundreds watching at one point, didn't we? Over a thousand at one point.
Yeah.
Which was really weird. But
people who are part of the church community now, who came as a result of watching in their PJs on Facebook.
Yeah.
And I think it gave them a chance to attend without being there.
I mean, obviously, you know, in Merseyside as well, and this is not necessarily the same. There's 39 local BBC radio stations, and this is not necessarily the same everywhere, but there's much more of a sort of a faith theme running through Merseyside, whether it's due to the Irish Catholic background, whether it's due to the fact that we've been a port city for over 200 years and lots of different nationalities coming in.
Yeah.
You know, the first mosque anywhere in the United Kingdom was here in Liverpool, wasn't
it? Is that
right? It's a place where faith is there as an undercurrent, even if it isn't, you know, the main thing in people's lives. I mean, look at how many times something happens in the city, sad or happy. And where does it happen? It's usually in one of the cathedrals.
Yeah.
You know, the cathedrals and the church community are often turned to as the place to harness that sadness or celebrate as well.
Yeah.
And I think that, I mean, if we look at our output on the radio station, you'll actually find faith-related stories right throughout the week. You know, churches doing, you know,
warm
pantries, warm spaces,
spaces,
groceries.
Yeah. We have one on a Wednesday,
like that, you know.
Yeah.
Wednesday daytimes, aren't we?
We do.
Yeah. In the church.
It was a warm space until we blew the power today.
We blew the power a couple of times today.
So, Tommy, fast us about radio.
Yeah.
Are you more of a podcast guy, or do you listen to the radio?
So I probably do listen to podcasts the majority.
That's the future.
Is it? Is that how does it work? I mean, do they put, so would they put, because I find a lot of radio stuff they put out as a podcast later or the highlights.
Just
or
teasing
things
little
like that.
Bits for people that haven't got time to, we want to dip their toe. So let's just play them a little bit.
Yeah.
And then like this, they would kind of then become part of something. Great.
Yeah. And I think we've recently, and you'll be pleased about this, Alan. I don't know, who do you support, Tom?
Arsenal.
Oh, get out.
I don't know if you've heard of them.
No, never heard of them.
Top of the league.
We've recently launched the Red Cop podcast at Radio Merseyside, which is a weekly podcast focusing on
Salty Old Breakfast Show presenter.
Yeah.
No. Very good.
So you're right, podcasting is, I mean, it's been around for a while, but it's
a threat to radio? How do you see it?
It's trends, isn't it, Paul?
It's different trends. And I think there's a certain amount, I mean, everything these days, whether you're listening or whether you're watching, I mean, how many things do you watch live on the telly?
Hardly anything. There's
nothing.
Yeah, the only things I watch live on the telly is football.
Yeah.
Oh, football,
news.
Yeah.
I'm a real news addict.
Okay.
The rest of it, I watch on catch-up, whatever you want to call it. And in a way, podcast is that thing, isn't it, really?
Yeah.
So, you know, but these days you can go, you can listen to, you know, I have got radios in my house, but all my radio listening is through smart speakers.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know, and you can get it to rewind it. You can stop it. You know, it's all about when you want it rather than when, you know.
But does that not, because we're doing this and we do it live.
We do this on purpose.
I like the community feel to the live thing. So when you get people phoning in live, there's something special about that. Yeah. And you're not getting that on a podcast necessarily, are you?
You know, Helen, you've been, this week you've been at Bootle Strand, haven't you?
Indeed, yeah. It was there yesterday and there tomorrow. Quick plug, 2 till 6. Voice of Eurovision, the BBC, the Radio Merseyside.
You guys are smooth because you are just moving us around nicely. I like that. This is how the pros do it. How are they doing it? It's like witchcraft.
Magic, and it's witchcraft. It's witchcraft.
We're supposed to do the religious show, but they're just, they're in our heads. I can feel it. Go on, tell us about Eurovision.
Yeah, so it is, of course, great news that Eurovision is coming to Liverpool in May, and it's a massive deal. So the BBC are going to have a Scouse alternative on the night, on the red button. So Claire Sweeney will be our main host.
What, doing the commentary or just people from the Strand performing?
No, we are going to various places.
Karaoke.
I've watched that.
I'm an audition. So we're giving the chance for listeners. A, we get out of the studio. We haven't seen many listeners because of lockdown and various reasons. This is the first proper time, isn't it, Paul? Yeah. A few years we've been out. So all this week, BBC Radio Merseyside has been in Bootle Strand, where people have been auditioning a 40-second reading a script and seeing if they've got that talent to be the person.
We could do it.
You haven't got a Scouse accent.
You don't have to have a Scouse accent.
I was going to say, I mean, that's a bit...
No, you just have to...
Surely you've got to, if it's a Scouse red button. Oh, well, you can't have a wolf on it.
Can you imagine me?
You can't have that. Sorry, Tom.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Scouse Eurovision. It's lovely to be with you.
I'm Australian. I don't know why I've gone Australian.
Exactly. It's gone up at the end.
Yeah. But the thing is, this is the first time it's ever been done in Eurovision. It's never happened before. In the history of Eurovision,
the local
commentary for whatever it is.
And what, so they're going to put that on the proper one, so you can have
it's going to be on the radio and on the red button.
So you could have Graham Norton, or you can have Alan from Boothville.
Get on it, guys.
Mate, the audience is going to be massive for that. I love it, though. What a great idea.
I'm going on audition.
You can do it at home and upload it to the BBC. Oh, upload it.
We'll do it tonight.
Where's the script? We'll do it now. Do it live.
If you're Bootle based, get down to the Strand. I'd love that.
Yeah.
You'll get a bag.
No, don't promise him a bag.
We've got bags.
Oh, do you? You get a bag. Oh, okay. Very good.
Where else are we going, Helen?
We're doing Birkenhead next week. We're doing St. Helens for a week. We're doing Runcorn. We're doing Greaty Market as well, which will be fabulous.
Yeah. Yeah. Greaty Market will be good.
Is that Great Homer Street?
Yeah. Greaty, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
See, I know.
Yeah.
Come on, Tom.
Great. Oh, that would be brilliant.
Yeah,
I was then in sixth form, and a mate worked with me in a cafe and said, Hell, I'm leaving. I've got this really great gig. I'm going to be making the tea at Radio City. It's a new Saturday morning show that's starting. Anyway, she did it for about a year. The actual program, have we got somebody gigging in here?
Don't worry, you keep talking. Oh, you keep talking.
Is that Pete Waterman? I'd be in school in the week doing my A-levels. Yeah. And over the weekend, his first task was he turned up in like an open-top car, say it was an MG, and it was lashing down. And it was my first shift, and he went, sort that out. And literally, I had to go and get paper towels and dry his car. I'm like, what with? And I was literally damping it down. But then I had to go in, and it was just utter brilliance.
Because he was massive
then.
He
was absolutely, Stockaking and Waterman. I'd be back in Chester when I went to school. He'd be in Japan. Oh, I've met Kylie this week. I've been recording Rick Astley. Oh, I'm doing a duet with so-and-so. It was just an amazing job. And for the 2 hours, it was a fiver. So they gave me my bus fare.
Yeah.
Still kept the paycheck. But I did it at a time when it was that real drive of Dead or Alive, yeah. Yaz. They were just coming one after the other.
Who are these people?
Artists.
Dead or Alive. Dead.
Round, baby, right round.
There you go.
Get with the beats.
Easy one. Yaz, the only way is up, baby.
Do you know what? A couple of people said the audio's dropped out, and I think that, thank God, it happened.
Is that what the person breaking in was?
Yeah, that was Joyce, very subtly saying.
Have you not paid the bill?
We haven't paid for that yet. I wonder. So,
how did you end up then doing the faith show? Do you mind talking a bit about faith? Yeah. Is that like pulling the short straw in the radio gig, or was that something out of your own interest?
I am of faith. I'm a practicing Catholic.
Okay.
And I went to a Catholic school, and when I finished my education, I was working in an office, and I just kind of had this epiphany one day of, oh, is this it? Is this it to be a pension? So I quit.
I did that when I was in a hole in the ground. When it was raining and mud everywhere, I thought, it's this it.
You do? Honestly, don't you? Well, and that was what happened to me.
And it was for me.
Yeah, I sacked off the job, which was really well paid. And I think by now, if I'd have stuck with it, I'd have got my pension and could have been playing golf somewhere. But I went off and lived with a religious order.
Wow.
And I was a youth worker for 3 years. So still doing the decks for the disco, keeping the little radio thing going. And then at the end of the 3 years, the kids that came from schools were either in a dark place. It was a different time then. We could sit in a room with them on their own. You can't do anything now. No. Obviously, very much, very much protecting the individual.
Yeah.
But we were transformational in just giving a space to young people to let them be themselves, to share in a faith journey, want to join us, you don't have to type thing. So they'd spend a week with us at a big old house in Wirral. I used to call it like the Adams family house. And when they were, they'd laugh at me when they arrived with my crucifix on and my, you know, Jesus sandals. But when they left.
Fairness, I'd laugh as well.
But it was such a great 3 years. It was one of the best jobs I ever had.
Wow.
And I knew throughout my lifetime, whatever role I do, faith is in some way part of it.
Wow.
And so doing the faith job was literally hitting gold because I thought, wow. And it's not like the sports presenters don't say, hey, Everton. They are multi in all the sports.
Yeah.
So I never did the faith show trying to convert people. Yeah. I was letting people know about stories. And then we'd get contacted to say, oh, hell. And Paul, when you were talking about so-and-so, bit like, you know, what life's about, really.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah, so not a chore. Love it. Just
incredible.
I have friends who challenge me about my faith.
Yeah.
But it's something I feel if I don't...
In what way? Like they might...
come on, hell, you're still doing that?
Okay.
Attitude.
Yeah. Nice.
But if I don't have my hour, I love going to church. I love just having that space for me and just having a silence of an inner... you know, moment with my God I always feel what my life be like without my faith.
Yeah.
You know, and I just know it's a big part of it.
I'm always amazed by people as well. And we've had to speak to a few different people here who have made decisions like that in terms of you, like giving up a job and be that decision being influenced by faith. Cause that's not just like a private personal thing, which faith can be as well, but also that is impacting your life.
Well,
your life is taking
financially.
A different course.
My mum went berserk. What are you doing giving up that job?
I thought she was Irish earlier.
Well, you said she is Irish. But the way I see it now, if I hadn't have made that decision, I wouldn't have ended up with the pathway, end up in radio.
Yeah.
So I always think things happen for a reason, and that decision way back when I was a teenager was the right decision.
Incredible. I'd love to see a picture of you in those sandals.
Oh, hideous. I was like Deirdre Barlow. I had a massive big glasses and a big bouffant.
Did you do socks and sandals at the time?
I do Crocs now and Crocs. Socks. But back then it was sandals, yeah.
See, I think sliders are back with socks now. Sliders. You can wear sliders and socks.
Can.
I can't. But you can't. No,
you can, Alan.
No, I know people do it, but you can't. They shouldn't. It's wrong. Yeah.
You're walking around on clouds.
I'm on cloud nine.
You should be rocking Crocs now, at least.
I don't want Crocs. I don't want Crocs.
Crocs are expensive. Tao's watching. Tao, how much do you pay for a pair of Crocs?
I sometimes buy the fake brands.
Turkey Crocs.
Ones. Rubbish ones, yeah. I've got a nice green pair. They're about 30 quid.
Are they Crocs?
Yeah, Crocs with the holes in the front and all that. Yeah.
Wow.
I've got four pairs. Gardening. Slippers,
yeah,
going out to put the bins. I've got different ones, different colors mean different things.
No, I love it.
Love it. So I've ended up to Paul's bins, with a fake story.
Go on, Paul.
Yeah. mine's far simpler than Helen. I was brought up in a Christian family, come from an Anglican background. Yeah. We lived down Scotland Road, originally till I was about seven. And then we moved to the countryside, otherwise known at that time as West Derby, which was the countryside at that time. And carried on. We went to a different church then, St Andrews Church, Clubmore.
That's a good one. Yeah, we always always tell us about that one.
It's a great
church. Yeah. Some great vicars over the years as well, and do a fabulous. We started up 21 years ago now. We always refer to it as the network, but St. Andrew's Community Network, which was a project we started.
I've heard about this as well.
21 years ago, I'm a trustee there. Started off doing very, very simple things like baby massage and baby clubs and things like that. And it's just gone on from there. Sadly, gone on from there. It would be great if we didn't need to do what we do. You know, that would be perfect. But obviously, we run the North Liverpool Food Bank now, involved with pantries, debt advice. We have a full team of people, staff of people now. And it's a great operation. But that was all born out of the church just recognizing that was a need in the area, just in Clubmore initially. And it just carried on from there. So my faith journey is much simpler than Helen's, really. I was just brought up in that environment. But it's been there right throughout my life.
Less Crocs.
No Crocs at all in my journey at all. There's been some, it's like everyone's faith journey, isn't it? There's the peaks and troughs along the way. I went through a very difficult time in the mid 2000s with job situation. My wife got breast cancer and she's fine now. She's great. But, you know, at that time, it really, when those moments happen, is the moment that you realize how important faith is in your life. Really, you know, it's that moment when you realize that the faith matters so much, because if you're not someone who, I mean, sometimes I'm a bit sort of jealous of those people who come to faith in their life, and it's sort of this big road to Damascus moment, which I didn't really have, because I was just brought up in that environment. I made my own decisions along the way, but just brought up as a member of the Boys Brigade and things like this. But, you know, when big issues happen in your life, personal issues, it's then that makes you realize how important your faith is, and also the community that surrounds you in your church or whatever that really come together for you. You know, and we've had really difficult times financially and things like that, and, you know, envelopes with some money and we're just being pushed through the vicar's door and with a note on saying, give this to Paul and Paula, you know, and things like that. So it was just really, really nice.
We need to know some biz mates to pay for this.
Buymeacoffee.com
/ Finnegan. Under the door or two. We don't mind. No, you could have been working for Clubmore.
Why?
because it was us or Club More who were going to get the Eden team.
Okay. Well, we did have Eden on board at one time. We had a
Daisy decided they didn't want you.
Yeah.
That's not me making that decision.
Yeah, that's what we did.
Daisy decided they didn't want you.
Yeah, we would have had you, Tom. We could have rescued you from Alan.
We could have.
Yeah. Tom's yeah. loved that Eden
about
bus.
Paths going different exactly. direction than yeah. that.
No, yeah. we had
what
the
did I do?
Sliding doors.
Yeah, we had the Eden bus with us for quite a while.
Yeah,
working with the local youth and things like that. So yeah, great,
great
operation.
Yeah, double decker bus, mobile youth, club.
Yeah,
which is great because if the young people kick off, you can just drive away. Mow a few of them over as you leave the car park as a warning not to chase you
next week. Especially when they're on the climb and wall.
I like the sound. The Sunday morning as well, just because the number of people who listen to that, I guess similar to this, who maybe don't go to church or don't have faith or don't come from that faith perspective.
As I said before, we get all sorts of listeners, and you know, it's not just people of faith. You know, we often get challenging texts and emails in, you know, about, you know, that person was talking absolute rubbish and things like that. But that's what it's all about.
Yeah.
You know, faith is not meant to be comfortable, is it?
You had a humanist on last week, didn't
you? Yeah, we had a humanist on the other week talking about, you know, the census that came out and
saying that
you know, the number of Christians has gone down and actually the age group of Christians is the older.
Yeah.
So we had a humanist on, you know, talking about that. And he was actually...
Did you say to him, there's only about, 0.1% who are humanists?
But we, you know, he emailed us later and said, you know, thanks for having us on. It was great to have the opportunity just to put our view over. And that's what it's all about, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. We do that. We do that here, don't we?
Yeah. We do that. We have people on. Yeah. We've had a few on. Yeah, we had Brendan on the other week. We haven't put it out because that was the week it broke.
It did break that
week.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sad that.
It broke.
Get them back.
Just had a yellow screen. That was all it was all night. But
some people watched for the whole thing. It's their favourite episode, apparently.
I thought it was The Simpsons.
Very good. And now you're on drive time, Helen. I've been told that's like the best slot on the
Breakfast
radio.
Show is the best slot.
Is it? Who's got that?
Second best
Salty.
Slot.
Because if you look at, Paul Salt. Presenter.
His name's Salty.
Just the whole
nickname.
Paul knows all the stats and stuff. You get up, most people are at home at that time of the day.
Okay.
And on a Sunday, you do well because you've got more time on a Sunday to listen longer because you're not rushing out to go to work. But the afternoon show is great.
How many people listen on an afternoon then?
I would say...
For our show?
Yeah.
It's probably about 50,000.
Yeah,
50,000. Yeah.
50,000,
yeah.
We do similar numbers.
Yeah. It's about 50.
50. That's not bad.
But the good thing about Helen's show is that, in a way, you get the best of both worlds, don't you? Because for the first couple of hours...
You'd have to go in at 9.
But there's sort of a shift change in the show, isn't there, really?
We do like a magazine-y type feel between 2 and 4. Competitions, bit of chit-chat, talk about what's happening in the day. And then after 4, it's very much news-led. So we'll feature stuff that needs updating. And we have reporters out and we'll try and just give people who've been at work all day, you want to find out what's been
flavor
happening.
Flavour of what's happened,
I think we've got the balance.
So,
right.
And
the
good thing is, you have to get, sorry.
The exciting thing is, because I've done the show a couple of times, but Helen does it every day. The exciting thing is that when you arrive in, you don't necessarily know what you're going to be
what's
talking about after 4 o'clock.
A bit like our late shows, Alan.
Yeah. I'm a bit like that now. Every Sunday, to be honest. I don't know what I'm going to be talking about today. Tom very makes good. Up, no.
Wow. Great. Yeah. Fantastic. Let's play a game.
Okay. Oh.
We're going to play a game. Right. I don't know if you've come across Wonky Donkey before. This is where we need some help at home, but...
I've heard the title, but I can't remember how
you can have a little dance.
You can't hear, they can't hear.
Oh, you can't hear the music. Just dance, pretend like.
Do this.
There you go. You done. Paul, do that again.
It. Do it again.
That was brutal, that.
Do it again.
Paul can't hear it, but...
No.
There you go. So, how it works.
Yeah.
Basically, I read out a clue, and the answer's got to rhyme. So I'll give you an example.
Okay.
Here you go.
It's got to be a real answer. It's got to be a proper answer.
What do you mean?
Well, it's just any rhyming word.
It's got to answer the question.
Okay.
Can't just shout 1966 or something, you know.
Crocs.
Crocs. Crocs socks.
New guy.
So, I said you're going to be good at this. So for answer, the clue could be pot the pale red snooker ball. And the answer's two words and they've got to rhyme. So, what's the pale red ball?
Pink.
And what do you do to pot it?
Sink pot. The pink.
Sink pink.
I've got it now.
Pink.
Right, got it.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does make sense.
Yeah.
Okay. Does Alan play pink. This?
Alan.
Yeah, hey, I smashed it last week.
Good?
Oh. Alan's got
we
better.
Had Peter Dowd on last week and he was rubbish, right? He got two.
Okay.
But he finished with a score of 11 because I helped him.
Okay. Oh, well, money to help me.
I'm not going
to
help you.
This could be on your show.
When he said, because he came on, Peter Dowd's message was kind of like, anyone can be an MP.
Yeah.
And then he did Wonky Donkey, and we were like, yeah, anyone can. That was terrible. I was helping him. I was like, going, the pale red, you know, you might say a pink color. Good guy, though, Peter.
He was. Yeah.
Okay.
He's top of the leaderboards as well.
No, you're going at the same time.
Oh, yeah,
so don't worry.
Help each other.
Oh, we help each other.
Oh, you're not playing against each other.
Oh, great.
No, don't worry.
Together.
Yeah. Good. Don't worry.
Yeah.
So if.
I've got to beat 11 in 2 minutes. Hang on, I've got to get the clock ready.
Yeah.
I'll do it.
All right. So shout in at home. Okay. So if you know the answers, shout them out. We'll see how many you get afterwards. Ah. Okay. Sync pink. Yeah. People are getting sync pink. Okay. Let's have a look. Yeah. Okay. Here we go. You got timer? Are you ready?
Yeah. I'm ready. After you've read the first question.
After I read the first question, we go. So the score to beat is 11.
11. Okay.
Are you going to help him or you're going to?
I might.
See how it goes.
Okay.
If he starts helping you, then. It's not going so well. Okay, here we go. The first clue. Rush money. Rush money.
Rush money.
Another word for money. What could it be?
Cash.
Yeah.
Fast cash.
It's got a rhyme.
Rush cash.
Splash cash.
Fast cash. Fast cash.
Rush money.
You could pass.
Fast cash.
Pass.
Dash cash.
Dash cash.
Go on. Now. Avoid solar rays. What's another word for?
Sun.
So avoid something.
Run sun. Fun son.
Bum son.
What are you doing?
Bunsen burner.
No, okay. Men's colognes. What's another word for men?
Fragrance, aftershave.
Another word for men?
Men, like toilets. What would you call the men? Men's toilets.
Gents.
Silent loo. Silent loo.
Big poo.
It's got a rhyme.
It's got a rhyme.
Silent loo.
Quiet.
Quiet.
What do you do when you
push flush?
Yes.
Push.
Yes. Okay. Fresh outlook.
Fresh outlook.
If it's fresh, new. It's
new view.
Yes.
New view.
Yeah. Helen's on fire. Proceed at a leisurely pace.
Proceed.
What's a leisurely pace? You're not moving fast.
Slow.
You're moving.
Slow.
Go slow.
Yes. Slow. Quick. Footwear. Stick your
Crocs.
Footwear. Stick your footwear. What's that? You stick something with
glue.
Yeah.
Glue.
And footwear.
Shoe glue.
There we go.
What a guy.
Immobile lorry. A mobile lorry.
Still.
Another word for a lorry?
Lorry.
Van.
Yeah.
Truck.
Van.
No, not van.
Truck.
Yeah.
Truck.
Truck.
Stop, yes, stop. Yeah. Silent salamander. Oh, what a great clue that is. Another word for a salamander.
Is that a witch?
Not that one, but the other one. A small lizard.
Oh, newt.
Yep.
Newt.
And it's silent.
Silent.
Mute.
Yeah, yes, come on, we've got time for one more.
Mix and talk together. It's a biscuit. Mix and talk together.
Mix.
And talk together.
Chat.
Yeah, it's a biscuit as well. It's a biscuit.
Digestive.
That's got a
hobnob.
Yes, hobnob.
Yeah, am I giving them that one? You gave them that last one.
Why does that say 2 minutes, 13 seconds? Then?
I was giving them a little bit of extra.
All right, we're giving them a little bit of extra. Let's have a look.
Are you going to count? 11. You haven't got 11.
No.
But you might have more than six.
Let's see.
Which was cleared off White Kids.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You're not last. 7, 8. Very good.
You're up there with Mikey and Charlie.
Yeah.
I think we got we got the gist of
it. You were getting used to it, weren't you? After a while, yeah.
That's good. You got more cards than that for every week.
Yeah.
Yeah. We don't do the same one. Well, that's why Alan was getting them.
No, we've got like a full box in them. Yeah.
What was that off? Was it Ant and Deck?
Yeah, it was originally, yeah.
Yeah, they got it from us.
They pinched it off us. We've been playing it for decades. And they stumbled on it, didn't
I? I have to say, my favourite answer of all time so far has been Big Poo. Which didn't rhyme and didn't really was a
it's
part
good,
of the clue.
But it's not right.
Do you need a toilet break, Eleanor? Anyway,
GMA.
I've got some. We do a little thing, Helen and Paul. We do a little thing called Tom's Top Tips. It's not working.
Nothing's working.
Oh, do you know what? We'll just do. You do it live.
Tom's Top Tips.
Tom's Top Tips.
Okay.
I've got a couple of tips for you. Okay, broadcast related. Okay. So you could take something away with you tonight.
You can make notes.
Well, I can text it to you later.
Oh, yeah, please do.
If you give me your number.
Yeah.
We can be friends. So here we go.
Go on.
It's kind of deep. It's stuff that you feels familiar sometimes, but I kind of just think about as the show's gone on.
Yeah.
And so I think in radio.
Locks them.
In radio, as in life,
yeah,
you have two tools. Yeah?
Yeah.
You still with us?
Yeah, yeah.
You're thinking about the poo again, aren't you? Sorry. In radio, as in life, you have two tools. Sound and silence.
Mm. Profound.
It's true.
Can you see that, though? That's right, isn't it? Because sometimes I think you don't have to be scared of silence, do you? You could pause. On radio...
And the way I would look at that, Tom, as well, is speaking and listening. Because
Well, don't try and up me on my one.
It's the same thing.
Go on.
But a
expand.
Great broadcaster, I think, is somebody that listens. You need to listen to what people are
saying. You need to listen.
Alan's a blunt tool. He's got one tool, and it's just talking all the time.
You need to listen.
What do you mean?
You always stop me talking.
Do you know what, Alan? There's two different types of people. This is another one for you.
Oh, go on. Oh, go on.
People who listen to hear and people who listen to respond.
Very good.
Oh, yeah.
You should write these down,
Tom,
in a book.
You should get a little fridge.
Where'd you get that one from? Because that's not even there.
You can have posters made with these. Yeah, I know. Walls.
They've done it. Quotes. Sometimes they have. We found some. But details. Like certain things I've said, but then people have attributed it to like Gandhi John Lennon
them,
sometimes.
Gandhi's pinched them off.
I can't believe that. Human.
Yeah. I can't get any money out of it. Yeah. The other one was, and this is more poetic, kind of just, I was just kind of feeling fun. And so I went with on some nights it looks like I'm reading but I'm not, I'm just thinking. On some nights I still believe that a car with the gas needle on empty can run about 50 more miles if you have the right music playing very loudly.
That's profound.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's
it
quite
is.
Kind of
yeah,
poetic
probably yeah, stupid but yeah.
Did you get it?
Rubbish,
no, I don't get it.
Because it's the way it makes you feel, isn't it, the music.
You've got no fuel, no.
You can't go anywhere, though.
Yeah. No, but it's like the magic
the car
of radio.
Will break down, and then your battery will run out, and the radio will go off.
Well, I guess so. Yeah. Do you know what, Emma? We did once run out of fuel on the motorway.
No.
Do you do that thing where sometimes
you don't drive?
She doesn't drive.
You don't drive.
No.
Bus queen.
Or did Paul, you get the bus tonight, or did Paul drive?
No, I drove to
luxury.
Paul, chauffeur.
Heated seats as well.
Oh, Paul! He has all those millions. Yeah. He's got doing BBC Radio. You got equal pay. You'd be able to afford a car. And so, Emma, once we were on the way down south. That's where I'm from originally, if you can tell. And on the way down, you do the thing where you see,
the petrol
service station.
Yeah.
And you think, I'll go for the next one. Because then it just makes it exciting for the next bit.
No.
Anyway, we ran out of petrol on the M6 and I had to wake my children up to inform them they needed to get out of the car and climb up the embankment to be safe. And Emma, as she climbed up, she kind of slipped off the side and she ended up with this massive bruise on her leg. That's a story that gets
took a chance.
That gets told fairly regularly.
What are you like?
Yeah, I know.
I can't get over you sometimes, you know.
Do Do you know what next week in Finnegan's is
Valentine's
night.
Valentine's Day. So we've got Emma, on the Wednesday.
Emma and Joyce are our guests.
Oh, we're going to treat them to a night in Finnegan's.
Isn't that lovely?
Yeah, Emma and Joyce romantic. Are coming.
So we'll, rather than
we'll dull the lights a little
night.
Bit.
They're here.
We're bringing them here. Where else?
Oh, isn't that
you're
fabulous?
Spoiling them.
Yeah.
Best.
Girls haven't lived, honestly.
I know. Well, I sometimes I get invited to speak at like church type events. And so one year I was speaking at a youth event. I took Emma bunk beds. Said I was taking her away for the weekend. And when we got there, I was speaking at this youth event and we were in bunk beds. So this will be right up there with that.
Yeah. All that way.
So we've got Joyce and Emma next week. Is Diane coming?
I don't know.
Could be awkward.
Yeah.
Finally, and we're going to have to do this live as well because it's broken tonight. But
what's
story on? Time. No, the buttons and all that worked. I think that's why they've stopped working. That's why people lost sound for a second. Oh. But we're going to tell a story.
Yeah.
So basically what happens at this point in the night, this is my, sorry, I'm just seeing that my Emma says, does your car have a CD player, Paul?
It does.
All right, yeah. I got one of my wife's albums there. You're going to have I'll listen to that on the way home.
Yeah.
And then we expect to hear that. We'll be up at 6 a.m. to hear that next Sunday.
Yeah. We'll tell you what it's like on a...
Yeah.
Very good. All right, let's see. My dad's asking if he's babysitting next week. Possibly, Dad. And yes, okay. So a story. And this is the point where we need you at home. There's been some contention. Mm-hmm. People are not sure whether they want someone who's wearing Crocs in at Finnegan's.
How dare they?
But there's someone else who says something about Paul as well, but it's fine. Big poo. People are loving that still. Okay, so story. So basically, have you got a story each?
We're getting to the story each.
Okay, great. Yeah, we've got time.
And the premise of the story, any guidelines or?
Just interesting or funny.
Okay.
But so, basically...
Yeah.
Go on, do you want to say? No, go on. No, you want to say everything else? You've just shot me in the corner.
I was going to say.
Sat me in the corner. So you to shut up all night.
You explain. Go on. You explain. I'll do the spit at the right moment. Go on.
Basically, we have a VIP members list, which is this behind us on the wall.
Love the little, it looks like out from here, you've got a little halo above the shamrock. It's great.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah.
So, I love that.
So this is the VIP members list, which means if your name's on that, you can come to Finnegan's anytime you want.
Laughing.
Anytime you come. It's a secret location. So, you know.
Okay.
But anytime you want. So you tell a story.
Yeah.
And if the people at home think your story's good enough, they get them on the wall, lad.
Do you ever do live jingles? Could you tell he did that live?
It was
they're not listening.
It was like a professional.
They're not listening.
I put some echo on it.
Oh, did you? Sorry.
We were quite a professional establishment.
Yeah. Yeah. but
have you got that that echo, effect? Yeah. Echo effect. Is that
but
a thing?
If you if the people at home don't think you're worthy of being a member of Finnegan,
okay.
Then you're bad.
That's okay.
Lad.
It wouldn't be the first place I've been bad from, so that's okay.
You're bad, lads, and you've got to go, and we can't talk to you ever again.
Okay.
No one's ever been bad yet.
Oh, okay.
It came close when we had a community police officer on, didn't we?
Yeah.
He was close.
And Peter Dowd last week, he came in, and I thought we were going
to... He's getting sick, this fella.
I thought we were going to get him.
Good.
Because
he's all right. He
was
great.
He was brilliant, but off the bat, we asked him what one of those was, and I was sure he was going to say nougat. But it was like someone had prepped him to say nugget because he was proud about it, wasn't he? And then I was like, he smashed it.
He read this song. If you say nougat,
you're a Tory. it's a fail.
So that's it. So,
okay, how long?
Any lads? Any? Just crack on.
I think people will thank you for brevity. That could potentially go down.
Yeah.
Well, but who goes first?
Okay.
Oh.
So my story is a true story, and it happened where Paul and I were invited to York to see the Archbishop of York, Reverend Stephen Cottrell. So it was a meet and greet with the media. Obviously, we are the BBC, representing BBC Radio Merseyside. So did we get the tray?
Yeah,
we've
got the tray.
Very big, grand property in a beautiful setting, lovely garden.
It's called the Palace, isn't it?
The Palace, yes.
The Palace.
So we're watching our P's and Q's. So other people started to arrive. And as you do at these events, you check out what's on offer with the ale and the nibbles. So we realised that, you know, they pushed the boat out with a lot of things. So Paul and I were working in tandem. So when the drinks started getting less in the glass, Paul would then go and do a refill. because we didn't want the same woman to say with her again. Yeah. So we took it in turns, and then other people at the event started to cotton on that our glasses were always full because we were literally doing the rounds. So as the event wore on, it got to the speeches, come and meet the Archbishop, lovely, absolutely great guy, yeah, and his family and other people who worked in the media. So then we went into the main house. He took us into his private chapel, which was just so beautiful. And then the story is lovely, but also funny in that I just had a bereavement with a family member, and the funeral, I think, was going to be either 2-3 days afterwards. And I just happened to say to the Archbishop of York, oh, will you keep Mary in your prayers for me? So he took me by the hand, led me back into his private chapel and said, do you want to sit and or kneel next to me? So we prayed together, and I thought, I am robbing his ale, going round the chimney, and it's allowed me to pray. And it was the nicest thing. And then he went into his little diary and he took the full name of my relative. So at the time of the funeral, I knew the Archbishop of York was going to be praying. Aww. And the funny thing was, we really buddied up, Paul, didn't we, with the catering staff. So when the, thank you, Archbishop, and then we were back in, going in to get more ale. And that's the story.
But, yeah, no, well, let's talk about the story finishes, because yeah, Helen has a good, we found a box of red wine, which had been pushed under the table because they thought everyone had gone.
Yeah.
And literally the Archbishop had locked the front door and gone to bed. And we were waiting for the taxi because we hadn't, somebody booked a taxi for us to get back to the railway station. So we thought, well, the wine's been bought.
Yeah.
They were assuming they were going to use it. So why don't we just take it for the journey? So we took a couple of bottles of red wine for the journey.
Yeah.
Taxi arrived in the nick of time. We got to the railway station only to find that the train was delayed.
Yeah.
So we decided to go for a drink in the bar. And the train was coming at something like 8:30 at night. And we, at about 8:20, we thought we better just go to the platform. We went to the platform. And as we got to the platform, the train arrived earlier than what it said it was going to arrive.
Yeah.
So had we waited in the bar and that was the last train, we'd have never got the train back to Liverpool. So anyway, we're on the train, filling our glasses up with this red wine, having a really good time, talking about the Archbishop of York and everything else. And I fell asleep with a full glass of wine in front of me. So I fell asleep.
Got this part.
Woke up just as we were coming through Edgehill Station to find that my glass was now completely empty.
Was this the work of Helen?
Yeah, she drunk it.
Helen
drunk
has a little red wine smile. little red wine smile.
Thank you, Archbishop.
I can't believe
it. So every time we see the Archbishop of York on the telly, we think,
we go.
Thanks for the wine, mate.
Cheers, mate.
Nicking his communion wine. That's what you were doing. That was for his Sunday service.
In the bar.
Yeah. Wow. You're not when you're praying, like going, have you got anything to confess? I've seen you necking that red wine. Wow, very
so
good.
True
wow.
story.
Yeah. That's
very
incredible.
Funny. I forgot the end, but you fell asleep.
Yeah. And Paul, is that your story as well? Or
no,
you
I've got a different story from when I was little, actually. This is a story I've told many
times. Does this involve you stealing alcohol as well?
No. I was far too young. I was at primary school when this happened.
Okay.
And I went to school in Clubmore, Roscoe, which is still there. And every so often, we used to go to Lister Drive when it was a swimming baths. And you know what you like when you're that age, about 9-10 years of age. And we got into, you know, the changing rooms, the old fashioned changing rooms then. Either they were singles or there was some communal changing rooms with about 8 of us in the changing room. So you know what young lads did? We all got in the changing rooms and somebody said, last one out stinks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Typical thing. So I thought, I am not going to be the last one out of this changing room. So I got ready. I was the first one out of that changing room. Went running down the sides of the pool and then realized why I was the first one out. Because I'd forgot to put my swimming trunks on. So I was charging down the sides of the pool in the complete knack. Because I was I didn't want to be stunk. So I was the last. So I had to run back and put my trunks on.
That's such a great story. Yeah.
Paul.
Yeah.
No shame.
So what we've got basically, if we let you into Finnegan's, is you're stealing our ale and Paul's running around naked.
They sound like the perfect members
you're
of Finnegan's.
Right in.
You're gonna fit right in here. Yeah.
Let us know what you think at
home.
Wow.
On this, yeah.
Let's have a little look and see what people are saying. Here we go. Here we go. On the wall, they're saying, waste not, want not with the wine.
Exactly. Yeah, good. Ray yes, said, agree.
On the wall just for the minesweeper abilities. And then Emma chimed in with wine sweeper.
Wow.
Very
wow.
good. Wine on the wall. Sweeper. Very good. Never
She's end- after one of these
A proper
bikes,
Bible story, never ending wine. Both on the wall. All right, we're going to stick you both on the wall.
You,
very good. Get
thank
you on the wall.
Very honest.
Yeah.
So, we're running out of space on the wall here, aren't we?
We didn't think this through when we started this, did we?
We
need a bigger wall.
We need
we're
going
to have a bigger wall.
So we're going to put Helen and Paul over yeah. here, I think.
Oh, fab. Oh, we've oh, made
I feel
it, Paul.
Completely honest
Forget
now.
BBC Radio Merseyside.
yeah, any the of them honours that you've had and all them awards that you've had. You know what I mean? Forget that. This is it. This is the pinnacle of your career.
That's great. Or going to get a picture.
Yeah. Yeah, and you have to come back. Come back again.
Oh, we will. Please, and you need to go on the Faith show with Paul.
Yeah, we've got to get you on, you guys on.
You did say we could come for that last hour, couldn't we?
You
nine,
said
yeah.
nine.
Yeah, you come for the 9 o'clock. Nine, and it'll be fabulous because we know that week will increase our listeners by 35.
Yeah, 35. Thereabouts. Some
There's
of them
no
are
bar,
a bit,
though,
some of them don't get up that early. They might have been here all night the night before. So
and we know we can steal stuff straight yeah. from the because it's been endorsed.
We can just borrow a camera.
Yeah.
We need another camera, don't we?
So we do.
A couple
we
of
do.
Microphones. Yeah.
Very good, yeah, very good. Well, I think all that's left to
call time on it.
Call time on it.
Thank you for watching.
Thanks very much. Thank you, Helen and Paul, for your
welcome.
Good sports.
Yeah.
So how can people, they can hear you when on?
They can hear me Sunday morning, 6 till 10.
Great.
And tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock, fantastic.
Yeah.
Great.
Oh, come and see me at Bootlestrand.
Bootlestrand.
Come and do your voice for Eurovision. Lads, come down.
Yeah. Alan, I'd love to hear you do the Eurovision. Even just the countries of that, that'd be amazing.
Oh, imagine, I wouldn't even be able to see them, would I?
You'd start doing accents and stuff.
I wasn't, so I'm not as daft as you. Yeah. You know.
What did you call me then?
Daft.
Oh, okay, all right.
What
I had something different.
I
don't know. Okay, moving on. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Lovely to have
you
with us. And we will see you all again next week. I think you're going to have to send
us
to the screen because it's not working. Yeah, give this a like and a share and a comment. And yeah, we'll see you again next Wednesday for a Valentine's night special.
Yes, Valentine's night. I'm looking forward to that.
It's going
to
be great.
We'll have candles. We'll have everything. So we'll smash it. We'll have paper flowers.
We're getting in trouble on this one. Anyway, good night. God bless.
Yeah.
See you again
see
soon.
See you later.
Bye.